Hey guys, so before we start this video, I just want to let you guys know what company hair I'm wearing in the video. So this video is a sponsor video by a company called, and then obviously you have the website here. The shipping was super fast. It was so quick. The hair itself is so nice, like it's really good. One thing I am in love with is the curl pattern on this wig. The curl pattern on this wig is to die for. The lace on this wig as well was so easy to work with, like literally. Obviously curly hair does shed. I didn't really get too much shedding. Even when I plucked it, I didn't really get a lot of hair coming out. The hair does get a bit dry at the ends, but just wet it and stuff and it will come back to life. I didn't put no water in this hair at all. Well, obviously it has four little adjusted clips inside, so obviously you can just pull it down and clip it. Then it has a bit here that I have not used, but because I don't really need to use it. But the hair is really good. Like I definitely recommend you guys to check out the hair. Like as soon as I put mousse in it, you see what I mean. Like I put mousse and stuff, the curl pattern is really good. I also realized that once you put mousse and stuff in it, like the curls stay like that, you see. Like sometimes you get couple hair, like hair that you get, the curls don't really stay, but I've only put mousse and this is the hair look. Like this is the texture, like it stays. I really like it, it's so nice. This is 150 density and it looks a bit full, like it doesn't look thin like I've got alopecia. Really good. Definitely make sure you check out the company. Their details will be in the description box below. Hey, Maggie!
What?
Are
you filming?
I'm about to film now.
You're so happy, I love it.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl, Miss R Fabulous, pretty from any side, Woyoi, and I'm back with another blood clot video for your head tops. Yeah. So guys, basically it's been a minute. You know, the last videos I did was talking about my surgery and my complications and things that I'm going through in life. But you know what, I'm gonna keep it real with you guys. Yeah, the girl is officially not in a relationship anymore with my last partner, and I feel like this video is just talking about things that I've been going through in my life. Been happy lately, like, and I feel like it has a lot to do with me fasting and me saying a lot of prayers. I feel like I've turned to God so much more now. Like the way I've turned to him is just like I've actually bowed down to him and say, God, I need you. Do you get where I'm coming from? And these are the things that I need. So I just feel like ever since I've been praying, ever since I've been fasting, putting 100% into God, a lot of things started to change in my life, and I'm the happiest I've ever been in a very long time. I felt like 2020 was the end of my life. Like I actually felt so many bad things was happening, you know, and I just wasn't in a good place mentally and physically. I'm not gonna lie to you. Like I said to you, like, I stopped doing my business, for my hair business. I stopped doing a lot of things. I'm back. Do you get where I'm coming from? And I'm back and I'm coming better. And you know, I've started my hair business again. So you guys, if you do want, you can purchase your wig units and stuff. So definitely make sure you click the links in the description box below. I sell bonnets, glues, everything. So definitely check out my business and order yourself some Bournemouth wigs. But yeah, like life got the best of me. I lost myself completely, and I feel like it had a lot to do with my relationship that I was in, and a lot to do with my physical appearance when it comes to my surgery. I feel like I didn't know how to get used to it, but like I said, I've gotten used to it now. I'm not bothered about my BBL anymore. Like I don't even give a fuck about it anymore. Like honestly, you ain't checking for me, cut me a check. So I'm not even bothered about that anymore. Do you get what I'm coming from? Like I'm feeling healthy, I'm feeling good, I'm feeling great within myself. Do you get what I'm coming from? And I'm just like so happy. Like, and I just want to thank God, because you see, God, he don't play with me. He don't play with your girl, okay? He don't do that. So I just feel like this year, 2019, was one of the bad years for me. And I feel like, and I want a lot of girls to understand, yeah, when you love somebody, you tend to put up with a lot of shit, and you tend to believe that that's how you're meant to be treated, because you're so unnormed to, that's how a man should treat me. I was in a relationship for 2 years and a couple months, and trust me, like, that relationship was not good. Guys, listen, there were so many red flags. There was so many shit that I found out years later. Like, a whole year later, I found out that things that has traumatized me and made me understand that that's not my portion. I shouldn't be with somebody like that. And I had a breakdown. I'm gonna carry on the story while I'm doing a get ready with me, because obviously like this video is a get ready with me. So obviously it's no secret that I was in a relationship for 2 years and a couple months, whatever. And you know what guys, I'm a type of girl, when I'm in a relationship with someone or when I'm talking to somebody, I don't look at what the person has. Do you get where I'm coming from? I will fuck with you based on how you make me feel or if I have genuine feelings for you. So I feel like when I met my ex, like I genuinely liked him. Do you get where I'm coming from? Like he was chasing me for a very long time. Like he used to message me all the time on Snapchat. I used to ignore him. So it's a thing where like he was chasing me or whatever, and I didn't pay no attention to him at all. And then obviously like it was just a day where I was sick, yeah, and I started talking to random people on Snapchat, and then I replied back to his message and he got my attention. Then we carried on the conversation, we carried on speaking, and then it took off from there. I feel like obviously on a normal day I wouldn't do that, do you get where I'm coming from, because I don't really talk to people on Snapchat, because Snapchat is just my thing's open to the public. So it's just like how I met him to us being together for so long. I felt like in that relationship I settled so much, because when I look back at my past relationships, like I don't settle, do you get where I'm coming from? Like I don't do that. And obviously I feel like a lot of people in my family was like, they liked him, they felt like he was a nice person until like a lot of things started coming out, until I started finding out that he's cheated on me so many times with so many girls. You know, he's cheated on me with a girl that he an ex that, you know, him and he was, it was just like a whole entanglement, like it was just too much. And then I got into a situation, found out something, and the ex told me something, and that's something for me you can't come back from. I feel like that for me was the biggest disrespect, like to cheat on me, but to cheat on me and get a girl pregnant is a whole different thing. Like, and that's something me personally, like I can't go back from. Like I just can't be with someone that's done that to me. We've been broken up, do you get what I'm coming from? But we would keep going back to each other. We kept going back sleeping with each other, like spending time with each other. He would come over to my house and spend time with me, whatever the case might be. And I just felt like we wasn't in a relationship, but we kept doing that with each other. And you know, it just went as far as it could go, to be honest. And I felt like with me, like I remember like the last time he came to my house and he stayed over, we got into like a massive argument, because I just like, you know when you've just had enough, like I just had enough, like, and I was saying to myself, like I keep sleeping with this guy, hurting my feelings, and I'm not over shit that he's put me through. This wasn't the guy for me, man. Like certain things that I was thinking like to myself, I've been with you for 2 years, you ain't ever spoilt me, you ain't never bought me anything. Like I don't want to eat 6 nuggets and chips, I don't want to eat takeaway food on Uber Eats. Like you ain't ever took me to a restaurant, you ain't ever spent money on me, you ain't ever made me feel like I'm the baddest bitch, which I am by the way, but it's like I didn't know my worth. And I felt like because I was so comfortable with him and because I was in a relationship for so long, yeah, it's like I was so comfortable with the way he was treating me, and I started to believe that that was how I was meant to be treated. Like I started thinking to myself, this behavior must be normal. And that's when you're in love with somebody, you're just blind. Like that's what happens to you, become so obsessed with that person. Like, and I just feel like I really hope this really wakes up a lot of girls. At the day in the beginning of our relationship, the second year of our relationship, we went out to eat at a restaurant, yeah, and he likes to say, because of who you are, like I don't really want people to be stopping us, because he's a very low-key guy, like he's a very private guy as well, do you get where I'm coming from? Like he doesn't really do social media, none of that. So I feel like because of who I was, he didn't want that kind of attention specificate over here. But it's just like, you knew who the hell I was before you got with me or whatever. Like I might have not been popping then when I was with him, but you knew the situation. And I just felt like that just, again, like I said, I was really blind in love, like, and I was so in love with this guy that I actually thought that he was the one. And I, like, not to sit and shit on him, but he has supported me in ways that nobody has supported me in. He has been there for me at times where I needed him, but I feel like physically, like, he didn't give me what I deserved as a person. I felt like because of who I was as well, it was a lot of things that he didn't like. And I can understand that everybody's entitled to their feelings. He does have a right to say, because at the time he was my boyfriend, do you know what I mean? And it's like, he would complain at things like, I don't want you posting pictures with your bum shown in the picture. I don't want you doing this. I don't want you doing that, you know? And also like, it was just a bit too toxic. It was toxic for me, man. I just couldn't do it anymore. Like, and I kept crying. Like I was just not happy in the relationship. Like, and obviously, especially finding out that like, he kept cheating on me, finding out like, fam, you're cheating on me with girls that look up to me, bro. You're cheating on me with girls that watch my YouTube channel, that fucks with me. And then it's like, once I find out about them, they find out it's me that he's been with, or whatever the situation is, these girls tend to come and now hate me. And really truly, like, I'm as sweet as it get. Like, I'm not a difficult person, do you get where I'm coming from? Like, I'm actually a very understanding girl. So these girls that don't like me over man is petty. Like, it's stupidness, because I can never hate a girl over a boy. Do you get what I'm coming from? Like, it's not in my portion. After that whole mess, I just kept finding myself in situations. I kept finding myself in a situation where people are messaging my phone saying, "Oh, you're sleeping with this girl's man." I'm thinking, but babes, he's my man too then, if that's the case. But like I said to you lot, yeah, I'm on big and better things. Like, I just got out of that relationship, and I feel like the way I got out of that relationship was God. Like, God really helped me get out of that toxic relationship. Like, I was so blind, and I didn't know my worth. I just allowed him to disrespect me. Like, and I'm a big girl, like, I should know better. Do you get where I'm coming from? Like, and do you know what it is? I just have a good heart, because there was times where, like, I would fully just, like, be done with this guy, and this guy would just come back, and I would just say that, like, okay, cool, because, you know what I mean? Like, but at the end of the day, like, you live and you learn and you make mistakes, and I feel like every relationship that I've been in, they've taught me something. And I feel like with this relationship, one thing it's taught me is never fucking settle. I felt like I settled in this relationship. I was the person that was always buying him stuff. I was the person that was always doing things for him. Do you get what I'm coming from? Like, I was the person that was doing so much. Like, he barely did anything for me physically when it comes to, like, money wise. I was the one, like, he will, like, phone me to do this, phone me to do that, and I will literally do it. Like, I would never say no. And you know, sometimes it just hurts, because you want that person to be like that. Just be like that the way you have them. Do you get where I'm coming from? I feel like that wasn't the case. Like, I would buy, and you see, my love language is buying somebody something. His love language is fucking me and telling me he loves me or whatever. But if that's not enough, like, sometimes I want to feel like I'm special. Sometimes I want to be spoiled. Do you get where I'm coming from? Say that he's a bad person. I don't think he's a bad person. I feel like, yeah, he's a lovely person. Do you know what I mean? But he has really bad traits. And I feel like his biggest problems are women. And me and him have had conversations where he's told me, yeah, like, my biggest problems are women. Like, my women would be my downfall. And I can't be with someone that just cheats on me, like, and doesn't value me or respect me or wants to show me off or want people to know that they're taken. Like, you won't make it clear that you're taken because you're talking to a lot of girls. And I feel like the straw for me was, a couple months ago, I went in his phone, right? And this was what I said to myself: if I go through this guy's phone and I see anything that I'm not meant to see. And guys, girls, we shouldn't be going through phones, because you know you're going to see some stuff. But me being Renee, nobody can tell me what to fucking do. I went through this guy's phone, okay? When I went through his phone, I saw a lot of stuff that I was so hurt and broken. Like, I went through this guy's phone, I saw him talking to his ex again. Like, I'm just thinking, you've told me, like, this whole time, you've told me that, like, you don't talk to this girl. This whole time you told me you don't fuck with this girl. And he was here telling me bullshit, do you know what I mean? And this whole time you was fucking this girl when she was in your bed on this date and that date. So it's like, I literally took the phone out the car, guys, and I walked away and I went AWOL. Like, I went walking somewhere around his area, and then I did FBI shit. I went through his phone, I went through his Instagram, I started seeing that he was talking to some girl, I started seeing that he had sex with a girl 3 days before he fucked me. Like, I started seeing so much stuff. Like, it was just so disgusting. Like, and my heart broke, do you know what I mean? Like, I was literally sitting there going through this guy's phone, seeing everything. Like, not only was he sleeping with his ex or doing anything with his ex, he was doing things with other girls. And to know that I'm sleeping with this guy and I'm giving this guy myself and I'm not using condoms with this guy, because obviously he is my boyfriend, like, I'm not expecting him to cheat on me, do you know what I mean? And this is why another thing, I feel like, girls, we need to be super, super careful who we decide to lay down with, because you don't really know a guy. Like, listen, when I tell you, it's mad. It's absolutely mad. The things that I saw was really, really sick. Like, it just made me upset, man. It made me feel sick as a person. I was thinking to myself, how can I love this guy so much, and this guy is just out here cheating on me, doing all these things, got me doing things for him, got me doing this, will call my phone, told me to do this, asked me to do this, and I'll fucking do it. Do you get me? Because I'm a raw ass bitch. Like, I don't even give a fuck. Like, you see me, when I love somebody, I love somebody hard. And it's like, I was embarrassed as well. You know, one thing that made me really embarrassed is that I'm going through your phone and I'm seeing you talking to these bum ass bitches that are not even on my fucking caliber. And it's like, you're out here chasing these lame girls that can't even buy you a fucking drink in the pub, or can't even fucking buy you something to eat, or a full meal, but you're out here giving your D to these girls and chatting to them and whatever, whatever, like, and I don't need to deal with no baby mums, like, all these things, like, it was just too much. Like, I would see his baby mum talking about me in text, like, it was just too much, and I feel like that, for me, was just the ending of it. Like, I honestly wish him the best, like, I honestly wish this guy the best. Because, like I said, guys, I did love this guy, do you know what I mean? Like, but it's just, for me, going through his phone and seeing all of that, I was just so done, like, and I kept, and the thing is, I kept going back to have sex with him, because I'm not just gonna sleep with any guy, like, that's just not me. I'd rather go backwards to an old thing, or go back to an ex-member that I've had a relationship with, and just fuck, and then get my needs and go, do you get what I'm coming from? But I kept going back to sleep with him, but it got to a point where I'm just thinking, it's not always about sex, like, sex, don't let sex make you forget your worth, like, let's settle for no guy, don't settle for no guy, like, honestly, I was not spoiled in that relationship. That man did not respect me. That man just enjoyed the feeling of having somebody that's independent, having somebody that has a shit together. Like, the things that he would say to me, like, Renee, these girls are not on your level, Renee, like, you've got your own house, you've got this, you've got that, like, do you know what I mean? These girls wish they had things that you have. Like, he knew, like, do you know what I mean? Like, he knew the kind of female I was. Like, I'm the type of girl, like, I like to take care of my people. Like, I like to take care of people that I love. You see, if I love you, I've got you for, like, I've got you. That's all you need to know. And I just feel like the way I loved him, I don't feel like he loved me that way back, because I was doing too much in that relationship. He was not really doing anything for me. Do you know what I mean? Like, and it got to a bit where, like, certain things in the relationship started to change completely, because obviously I started to deep that raw. Like, the reason why you was acting like this, or you never had time for me, was because you have a whole nother life. Like, this guy had a whole nother life that I didn't know about, and I had to find out by his ex. That's another story time for you lot. I will tell you lot that story time in another YouTube video. This video is literally just a life update. Like, let's be cute with it. Do you get where I'm coming from? I'm not here to drag anybody. I'm just simply trying to say, ladies, know your fucking worth. And do you know what? From today, Renee will not fucking settle. From today, Renee knows who the fuck she should be with. And that's on period. Do you understand? Like, I've moved on. I'm happier. I'm in a better place. I've met somebody so much, much better. You know, I've met somebody that treats me like a fucking princess. And you know what it is? Like I said to you, like, it has a lot to do with God. Like, people have asked me, how did you get out of that 2 years relationship? How did you do it without, do you know what I mean? Like, I had a mental breakdown. Like, Maggie was here when I was smashing everything in my house. And no man in this world should make you act like that. Please, ladies, no one should make you act like that. I was smashing things in my bedroom. Like, I broke my lamp, I broke my bedside tables, I ruined my room, do you know what I mean? And then when I was finished, like, I had so much anger, so much pain built up inside of me for so long in this relationship, yeah? I just couldn't physically do it anymore. Like, I had a breakdown. I was screaming, bogeys was coming out my nose, water was coming out my mouth, I was hitting Maggie. I was just like, Maggie, like, I'm done, Maggie, I'm done. Like, I can't do this no more, Maggie. She's like, Renee, you deserve better. Maggie was just literally amazing. I need everybody to go over and subscribe to Maggie's fucking channel and give her a heart for me, because that girl deserves it. She is a good friend. Like, she was there. She saw me at my lowest. I was at my lowest. I went off social media for three days. I just couldn't do it. Like, I couldn't fucking do it. Like, I had a breakdown, and he was on the phone, and he was listening to me crying, screaming. Like, I was letting out all the anger and pain, like, everything that this guy has put me through. To have a baby on me is a big thing, do you know what I mean? Like, to have kids on me is mad. Like, that was something that was so hard for me to actually do, because it's like, I wanted a kid and you gave these other women kids. Like, it was really painful for me, and I'm not gonna lie to you, like, it was so hard for me to deal with. It was so hard for me to deal with. I just couldn't believe that this man had a whole nother life, and I didn't know that he had this life. Like, I didn't video. And do you know what it is? Like, I had to really just pray, guys. I had to pray, you know. I had to really, really sit down and kneel and ask God to help me, because I let, like, how can I allow a man to treat me in that way? Do you know who the fuck I am? Do you know what I mean? Like, there's guys that cat to chat to me and talk to me, and I'm out here being loyal, being faithful to a guy that doesn't even understand how to be loyal to me. Like, I just had to understand, like, Renee, you deserve better. Don't settle. Like, I should be treated like a princess, being spoiled, being loved, somebody that's obsessed with me. And I finally found that in somebody else. Like, I'm so happy, guys. Like, I've never been this happy in so long. So I was fasting I was fasting, I was praying every day without a fail. I was fasting between 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. And literally, when I say fasting, I wouldn't drink any water, I wouldn't do anything, I was just fasting. And then after I finished fasting, like, I would say a prayer before and I would say a prayer afterwards, do you know what I mean? And then I would end my fast. Like, God really had me. And when I say God doesn't play about me, he doesn't play with me at all. Like, God's got me, and I know he does. Like, I love that. I love him so much. It's unbelievable. Like, he's amazing. Honestly, if it wasn't for God, I honestly feel like I'd still be in that relationship, because I was having the worst breakdown ever, smashing up my room and stuff. It was out of this world. Like, I was so embarrassed at myself. I was like, Renee, how fucking dare you stay in a 2 years relationship and allow a man to treat you like this? And obviously, I used to always, like I said, the whole time of the relationship, we'll have our good days, we'll have our bad days, you know what I mean? Like, one minute he'll make me feel good, next minute I'll be feeling shit. And I just feel like I just didn't understand my worth. And I'm 25 soon, there's so much things that I want, you know, and I've been praying for so much. I've been praying for God to send me a good man, God to send me somebody that will love me and take care of me and, like, respect me and understand, like, I'm just a different type of female, do you get it? And I just want girls to understand, yeah, if a man really likes you, he will make time for you and he will treat you right and he will treat you like a queen. And do you know what it is? I felt like I settled so much because I knew that this man wasn't going to do anything for me in the way I wanted. I knew he wasn't going to spoil me the way I wanted him to spoil me. I knew that he just wasn't going to do that. And I still stayed knowing that I wasn't going to get that kind of love that I wanted. Do you get it? And as much as I want to blame him, I have to blame myself, because I'm the one that chose to stay in that relationship where I could have gone. And I had to, and I was so proud of myself when I broke up with him, because I was just like, you know what, Renee, you deserve better. And I had to just leave that relationship and just let him know that I love you, but you're just not meant for me. Do you know what I mean? Like, you're just not for me. I deserve a real man, but you're just not a man for me. Do you get where I'm coming from? And after my prayers, after my fasting and stuff, you know, I was just finding myself. And I remember I got up and I went to the studio to do WOYOIIS remix. Yeah, I went to the studio to do WOYOIIS remix and whatever. And then it's like, God said, today I'm going to put somebody in your life that's going to treat you right, that's going to turn your frown upside down. I want you to be so happy. Guys, be careful of who you call the love of your life, because the guy that I broke up with is not the love of my life. It was a phase, I'm telling you. You need me to go through all of that to understand, now you deserve better. Now I'm going to show you, stop settling for what is not for you. And honestly, guys, I'm a firm believer in everything happens for a reason. Do you understand what I'm saying? I kept saying to God, this is my last time. Like, this is my last time. The amount of miscarriages I've had with this guy, yeah? And I know why. God just didn't want me to have a child with him, because God said, Renee, you deserve better. This is not your portion. This is not your portion. You are here, not there. Do you get where I'm coming from? So there's a lot of things that I had to deal with. There's a lot of things I've dealt with in that relationship. There's a lot of things that traumatized me in that relationship. There was a lot of pain and hurt there. I don't hate him. I wish him the best. I don't dislike him. There's no hate in my heart for nobody in this world. Do you get where I'm coming from? And, you know, I feel like fasting and praying really, really helped me completely. I feel like if I didn't fast and I didn't pray, honestly, guys, I would be in a very, very bad place. But fasting and praying really, really helped me. It healed me. And I'm 100% healed. I'm 100% healed. I don't really think about that relationship no more. I don't. Like, I'm in a happy place. I'm in a whole new relationship. You know, I'm happy, you know. And this guy just makes me so happy. Like, he spoils me. He takes care of me. He treats me so good. Like, and in due time, you know, what's meant to be out there will be out there. Right now, I'm just in my space, enjoying who's for me. I literally want you girls to understand, yeah? Please, please, please stop settling. Don't be like me and settle. Like, I feel like I want all my girls to have a standard for yourself, okay? If you believe that, you know, you don't want to be with no guy that can't do this, can't do that, that's fine. Like, don't let people say to you, oh, you shouldn't go for guys that have money, whatever. Listen, You don't want no guy that can't treat you, can't take care of you. You don't want that for yourself. Do you get where I'm coming from? Like, listen, set your standards very high. Please don't settle. Like, it's taken me to be in 3 relationships, and one of them, that one person that didn't treat me good at all, spent money on me. Do you know what I mean? For me to realize that, Renee, you deserve fucking better. Do you know what I mean? Like, the girls that he cheated on me with, they just ain't me. Do you get where I'm coming from? Like, he always came back to me. Do you know what I mean? Like, but it's not adapting no more. Like, the girls that I would see him fucking with made me feel embarrassed to even call this guy my guy, because it's like, babe, if you're gonna fuck with bitches, like, make sure these are bitches that I can respect. But I can't be fucking seeing the bitches that you're fucking with that are just lames. Like, these are girls that fucking watch my channel, bro, that look up to me, that I got them screaming woyoi, and you're out here fucking with these lame ass birds. Like, I just couldn't, do you know what I mean? Like, at the end of the day, I'm a bad bitch, period. Like, I'm real. What you see is what you get. Has your bitch got her, my name in her mouth? And it's like, I don't even know you, sis. Like, I mean, you ain't ugly, but you just ain't me. Because, you see, my woyo is completely different to these bitches. Like, I don't know what they're smoking, but it just wasn't on my caliber. But, guys, we won't even speak on that ex of mine. We won't even speak about what I've been through in that relationship. I just wanted to come and give you a life update. You know, I'm getting healthier. I'm getting better. I'm so happy. You know, I came out of that relationship, I bagged myself a fucking real nigga. Someone that knows my worth. Somebody that's obsessed with me more than I'm obsessed with him. Like, I'm not saying I don't like my new guy. I'm not saying I'm not obsessed with him, but he's obsessed with me. And that's how it's meant to be. Like, you're meant to be with a guy that's obsessed to have you. Do you know what I mean? Like, I can't even get my hands off him. Like, he makes me so happy. He spoils me. You know, he takes care of me. He's just amazing. Like, the way he makes me feel, like, is unbelievable. Like, shout out to my new nigga, because he's doing his shit. Do you know what I mean? And, you know, hopped out of that relationship, jumped in a new thing. It's like, when I look at my guy, yeah, when I look at my boyfriend right now, when I look at my boyfriend, I see, like, I can see how he is. Like, I see the way he carries himself, the way he's bougie. Like, he's fucking bougie, and he has to be, because, babes, like, he ain't a normal guy. Do you know what I mean? So I'm just so happy right now. I'm so content. Like, all my friends love him. You know, my friends see him come in my life and do things and help me, and just, he's been so lovely and genuine. You know what I mean? And I'm so happy, and I just have to thank God, because God did his thing. God doesn't play with me. God says, you know what, Renee, I've seen you've been going through so much. I've seen that this guy has been deceiving you. I've seen that this guy has hurt you. This guy has broken your heart, your trust. That's living a double life. And I'm gonna bring a man that's for you. And just like that, without social media, I met this guy face to face randomly. Like, it was just so random the way everything happened. But guys, I literally just want to say to all my supporters, thank you guys so much for supporting me, guys. Thank you guys so much for loving me. Woyo Remix is out this month. Definitely make sure you are ready for the drop, okay? And please don't settle. Do not settle, ladies. Like, don't settle for these broke ass niggas. Don't be settling for these niggas that I can't do shit for you, sis. Don't be settling for these niggas that all they're gonna do is cheat on you. Like, you deserve better. Keep telling yourself that. I thought I wasn't gonna be able to get over my ex. I got over my ex and jumped into a new fucking Benz. Like, do you know what I mean? Like, my new nigga is just, oh, like, I'm settled. Like, my new boyfriend has shown me why I shouldn't settle. Like, he's come into my life and said to me, bruv, like, why are you settling for these guys? Like, do you know what I mean? Like, sometimes you just need to go through really bad things in your life for you to understand, like, yeah, like, you need to do better. Like, and I'm just so happy. Like, see me, I protect the people that I love. And that's just the vibe. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And I see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.